Dear students, in the previous class we have studied the rice gelatinous mechanism for the decomposition of ascorbaldehyde. Following half order candidates. Now, today the next topic or the next part we are going to study the same rice gelatinous mechanism for the decomposition of ascorbaldehyde. Following 3/2 order reaction or the order following 1/2 order kinetics. Okay. Now in this type of reaction, the chain initiation reaction will be first order, and the chain propagation and chain termination follows second order kinetics. Okay. Now the thermal decomposition of ascorbaldehyde also follows 1/2 order or 3/2 order kinetics. The reaction scheme can be written as: first, ascorbaldehyde decomposes to give methane radical and aldehyde radical. The aldehyde radical is not the reactive intermediate because it decomposes to give hydrogen gas. Whereas the reactive intermediate, the active radical here is methane radical. Therefore, in the propagation step, it converts all the ascorbaldehyde into product, that is methane, and again acyl radical is formed. Okay? Again acyl radical is formed. Here the product is methane. Okay, here the major product is methane. Then this acyl radical decomposes to give again methane radical and carbon monoxide. And in the chain termination step, the methane radicals combines to give ethane. The rate constant of these four steps are taken as K1, K2, K3, K4, and the corresponding activation energies are E1, E2, E3, E4. Now we are going to write the steady state equation for methane radical, okay, which is the reactive intermediate in this case. Okay. By using this reaction scheme, I am writing the steady state equation for methyl radical. Steady state equation for methyl radical is, as usual, I am writing, you will know that the rate of formation is represented by positive sign and the rate of decomposition is represented by negative sign. Therefore, I can write it as K1 into concentration of ascorbaldehyde minus K2 into concentration of methyl radical and ascorbaldehyde minus K3 CO minus K4 CH3 square equal to 0. Here, in the case of first step, and the methyl radicals are generated, in all the three steps, the methyl radicals are used. They undergo combination. So it is represented by minus sign. Okay? Now, similarly, I am writing the steady state equation. For the acyl radical, using these two equations, I am calculating the concentration of methyl radical because methyl radical is a reactive intermediate. The rate of formation of product mainly depends on the concentration of methyl radical. So therefore, using these three equations, I am calculating the concentration of methyl radical as C. The concentration of methyl radical on simplification, I can write it as K1 by K4 power half concentration of acetaldehyde power half. Here the main product is methane. Okay? The product is methane. So therefore, the rate of formation of methane, or if this is the rate of formation of methane with respect to time, I can write it as, it depends upon the second step, K2 into concentration of methyl radical and concentration of acetaldehyde. Now I am substituting the value of methyl radical in this equation. Then I can write it as, it will be K2, K1 by K4 power half. Okay? Power half. And here acetaldehyde power 1 and acetaldehyde power half, 1 and half, it will be equal to CH3, CHO 3 by 2, 1 and half. When I add these two, power 1 and half, it will be equal to 1 and half, it will be equal to 3 by 2. So therefore, I can also write here the rate of this reaction. The rate expression will be K2, K1 by K4 power half concentration of acetaldehyde power 3 by 2. So therefore, this rate of this reaction is mainly depends upon the 3 by 2 power of the concentration of acetaldehyde, and it is directly proportional to the concentration, that is the rate constant K2. That is the rate of propagation step. Okay? The rate of this reaction directly related with the rate of propagation step, and also it is directly depends on the 3 by 2 order of the concentration of acetaldehyde. Now we are going to calculate the overall activation energy of this reaction. Okay, by substituting the K2 as A2 into the exponential of E2 by RT. Similarly, K1 A1 into E power minus E1 by RT, and K4 equal to A4 into E power minus E4 by RT. That is, we are going to calculate the rate activation energy. This is the rate constant in terms of frequency factor and activation energy. On substituting these values in this equation, I can write it as the rate of this reaction will be equal to A2 A1 by A4 power half exponential minus E2 by RT plus E1 minus E4 divided by 2RT into concentration of acetaldehyde power half. Sorry, power 3 by 2. Then the overall activation energy calculated. The overall activation energy calculated using this on simplification, I can write it as, it will be equal to E2 plus E1 minus E4 divided by 2. That means this E2 is very much lesser than E1. Okay? that V2 is very much lesser than E1, the overall activation energy will be larger than E1. This accounts for the activation energy which is larger than the energy required for CC bond cleavage in the case of acetaldehyde, particularly in the case of chain initiation step. The activation energy calculated is greater than E1, that is greater than 80 kilocalories per mole. Now, using this, now we are going to calculate the chain length of this reaction, which gives the average amount of reactant converted into product. We know that the chain length will be equal to the ratio between overall rate and the rate of chain initiation reaction. What is the overall rate of this reaction? It will be equal to K2 K1 by K4 power half concentration of acetaldehyde power 3 by 2, and the rate of chain initiation reaction is K1 into concentration of acetaldehyde. Then what happens? When it goes up, it will be minus 1. 3 by 2 minus 1 will be equal to half. So therefore, the rate will be equal to K2 K1 by K4 power half acetaldehyde concentration power half. So this is the rate of the chain length of this reaction. So the chain length of this reaction is chain length will be K2 by K1 by 4 half acetaldehyde power half. The chain length or the rate of formation of product is directly related with K2, that is the rate of propagation step, and it also depends on the square root of the concentration of acetaldehyde, and it also depends on K1 and K4, and it is inversely related with K4, that is the rate of chain termination step. So this is how we are calculating the chain length of a reaction following 3 by 2 order reaction. The next topic we will study in the next class.